म्हणून सर कोणाला सकाळी सकाळी की सर त्याला पत्र पाहिजे तुम्ही. आणि मी म्हणलं पत्र पण देतो तरी म्हणून रजिस्टर नाम चाललंय म्हणलं म्हणजे 100 रुपये दिले तरी काय प्रॉब्लेम नाही, पण पत्र मात्र महत्वाचे. लॉग इन ला केलं की पटकन लॉग इन ला करा. तुम्हाला मी एकदा तुम्हाला एकदा पोस्ट करून टाकतो तुम्ही करा मॅनेज लगेच पटकन. तुमची युट्यूब लिंक जनरेट झाली त्याच्यावर तुम्हाला जॉईन झाले करता येणार नाही. तुम्हाला जॉईन तुम्हाला तिथं दिसणार आहे ती. दादा सर जॉईन होऊन घ्या तुम्हाला पोस्ट करणार रोज लय मला व्हायचं जॉईन करून घ्या मला जॉईन करून घ्या. आज काय झालं नाही मी नाही तुमचं तुम्हीच करणार. आज मी काय करणार नाही असे काल त्यांचं काही त्यांची तयार जेवलो नाही. दादू सर त्यांनी घरी मटण केलं होतं त्यांना विचारा पाणी पिऊन त्यांच्या जेवतले बाजूला. त्यांनी दादू सर गेले गेले नाश्त्याचे पेट म्हणलं नाही नाश्ता पण घेणार आणि काय समजू चहा होता चहा नाही दादू सर चहा विचारा तुम्ही राठोड सरला विचारा असे करा की जॉईन करा की तुम्ही ते माझ्याकडे डबल नेट चाललंय युट्यूबला पण चाललं याला पण चाललं तुम्ही पटकन जॉईन करून घ्या. म्हणून म्हणतो तो मी तुम्हाला उशिरा लिंक देतो तुम्ही लगेच पाहिजे लगेच पाहिजे 14 मिनिटाला मी लिंक करून अहो तुम्ही त्याला जॉईन झाले तुम्हाला तिथंच दिसणार लिंक तुम्ही जॉईन करा. मी माझं व्हॉट्सअप त्याच्यापेक्षा कॉपी करायची तुम्हाला तुम्ही पोस्ट करणार मला याला व्हॉट्सअप माझं कनेक्ट करावं लागेल त्याच्यात लावावं लागेल त्यापेक्षा तुम्ही जॉईन झाले तुम्हाला तिथे तिथं जॉईनच व्हायचंय ना आता तुम्हाला मला परत पोस्ट करा तिथं तुम्हाला म्हणजे तू जॉईन होणारच नाही का मला एवढा वेळ नेट चालू करायला लावलं मला कसं क्रिएट करायला लावलं आता तेवढं 15 मिनिटात नेट सुरू झालं माझ्यावाला इथं. हा त्यांना म्हणलं युट्यूबला जॉईन व्हा तुम्हाला लिंक लगेच मिळून जाईल सगळं. 9 रुपये वेटिंग लाईक्स पठरे शरण त्यांच्या आईडी मध्ये पठरे सर आयडी करू का पठरे काल काय मजा आली राहू यायला सगळ्या गावात पठरे सर आणि मी मध्ये प्राचार्य साहेब प्राचार्य साहेब हॅलो म्हणजे कमीत कमी हे आणल्यामुळे त्यांना कळलं असं का हे चाललंय
युट्यूब
लावलं
नाही
आहे कसं त्याच्या सेटिंग मध्ये काहीतरी बदल करावा लागणार बरं का परवा दिवशी हो आता कणी माझ्या लक्षातच नाही बोलू नका काय झालंय हे सगळं
ফোন করি তাহলে শুনতে পাবো।
All the participants are requested to mute their sound as well as video. All the participants are requested to mute their sound as well as videos. सर असू दे तू काय बिघडत नाही सर बंद कर सगळ्यांचे व्हिडिओ काय भानगड तुम्ही स्क्रीन करा की सगळ्यांना काय प्रॉब्लेम नाही सर माझं चालू
He's smiling good all. I love it.
And if you just see your face, she can still be lecture. It still looks like a lecture. Like, my dear, you know how I
The participants are requested to mute their audio as well as videos for better bandwidth. All the participants are requested to mute their audios as well as videos for better bandwidth.
ছবি দেখা যাচ্ছে না
क्यों करतो ओके आता काय अडचण नाही नो प्रॉब्लेम आता झालं
All the participants are requested to mute their sound as well as videos for better bandwidth. Otherwise, you will not enjoy the slides, even sound also. Please.
हाँ मकरंद बोलते पण मकरंदचा आवाज नाही आता. हाँ
हेलो हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर मकरंद मोहनराव ऐतवडे. वार्म वेलकम फ्रॉम रयत शिक्षण संस्था शरदचंद्र पवार महाविद्यालय लोणंद फॉर टुडेज नॅशनल वेबिनार ऑन प्लांट डायव्हर्सिटी ऑफ कोंकण ऑर्गनाइज्ड बाय डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी. द स्टडी ऑफ नेचर गार्ड्स अगेन्स्ट प्री जस्टिस. द कोट ऑफ father of taxonomy, that is Carl Linnaeus, makes us moving continuously and consistently in the nature. In these centuries, the code becomes real. In the nature, there are many marvelous things and science behind them need to be studied. Our India is one of the 17th megadiversity centers in the world and nurture huge diversity. The flowering plants are highest importance for man as they provide all basic needs. Nowadays, there is tremendous pressure on our plant diversity. So, due to overpopulation, habitat destruction, modifications, pollution, industrialization, there are many threats to our biodiversity. Now, the plants play a key role in ecosystem and contribute major component of biodiversity. The biodiversity documentation and conservation is an important task ahead for 21st century botanists, especially taxonomists, need to play crucial role in charting, describing and documenting biodiversity and decide priorities for conservation. Taking this consideration, we have organized this webinar to know plant diversity of Konkan in different season, to understand their present status and conservation, and to light on new discoveries from Konkan region. Now, I request our principal sir, Dr. T.N. Gholap, to give inaugural address regarding national webinar.
Good morning to all of you. Today is our resource person, participants and my dear friends, all of you, warm welcome at this webinar. Pandemic COVID-19 brought new era of online teaching learning process, that is e-learning. First of all, I congratulate Department of Botany for organizing this national webinar on plant diversity of Kokan. I thankful to all the participants for their huge response. Now we are facing many natural calamities like global warming, climate change, cyclones, hurricanes, etc. To overcome this problem, we have to conserve our biodiversity. Lands plays major important role in balancing biodiversity. We have huge biodiversity and hot spots of the world. Every component of this society must know diversity around them. Biodiversity is under threat due to different anthropological activities. It is a need of time to conserve our biodiversity for our better future. I hope this webinar on plant diversity of Kokan nature, you all regarding this present status and conservation. I express my best wishes for such academic event. Thank you. Good morning to all of you.
Thank you, sir, for your inspiring words. Now, I request convener of this webinar, Sri Yashan Jadhav, sir, to introduce today's speaker. Please, sir.
Good morning, everybody. I welcome you again for national webinar on plant diversity of Kokan. This webinar is organized to explore plant diversity of Kokan. It is my pleasure to introduce today's chief guest, Dr. Arun Chanduri. His PhD in floristic studies on monocotyledons of Belgaum district. He is a research guide from Mumbai University. His teaching experience 8 years and research experience 13 years. He has a prestigious award, that is Young Scientist Award in 2012. Professor Sabo Award in 2016, Excellent Scholar Award in 2017, Fellow of IIT in 2014. His research paper presented in foreign countries, 3 papers are presented. His research profile, that is the paper near about 20 major research project completed and ongoing, 2 minor research project, 3 completed. Research paper published in journals 70 and paper presented in national and international conferences 56. Resource person in seminar and conferences at times, and he delivered lecture as a member of live member and fellow of Indian Association for Angiosperm and Taxonomy and membership of International Association for Plant Taxonomy. He organized 5 research 5 workshop. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I request our today's resource person, Dr. Arun Chandore, sir, to deliver his talk. Arun, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Good morning to all. I am very much thankful to Dr. T.N. Gholap, Principal of Sharat Chandra Pawar Mahavidyalay Lonan, Professor S.N. Jadhav, Convener, Professor M.M. Aitode, Coordinator, Professor N.L. Salunke, and all member of organizing committee for organize such a nice activity. Today, my presentation topic is plant diversity of Konkan region, and I am talking on especially new discoveries from lateritic plateaus of Konkan region. Konkan Konkan is generally land between the Western Ghat and the Arabian Sea. It starts at Tapi River in north and it ends at Chandragiri River in it runs from six districts in Maharashtra. Konkan includes all coastal districts: Mumbai, Raigad, Ratnagiri, Thane, Palghar. In India, there are two biodiversity hotspots. One is Western Ghat and another is Himalayan region. And total 34 biodiversity hotspots are reported from entire world. Statistical record of plant diversity, approximately 17,500 angiosperm species are reported from India, and it is highest number of plant among plant diversity, followed by 64 species of gymnosperm, then algae having 6,500 species are reported. Fungi reported about 14,500 species, bryophyte 2,850 species, pteridophyte 1,100 species, lichen 2,017 species. Total 87,285 species belong to five family and covered about 29% diversity of angiosperm families. The five angiosperm families, top five, Asteraceae, then Orchidaceae, Fabaceae, Rubaceae, and Poaceae. Asteraceae with highest number of species, about 22,750 species, followed by Orchidaceae, 21,950 species, then Fabaceae with 19,400 species, Rubaceae 13,150 species, and Poaceae reported about 10,035 species. Angiosperm is the captain of present day of diversity. Rest of angiosperm organisms are guest of angiosperm. About 20 to 60 species are depend on single tree species for their survival. This is evergreen and semi-evergreen forest type. Then this is deciduous forest type with bamboo beaks, scrub and thorn forest type, secondary forest. This is moist deciduous forest and dry deciduous forest. Here vegetation along side of river. Here unique type of diversity we found along the river side. Some forest areas of Konkan region. Here I'm showing some photograph. This is from Sunakolon area, waterfall and surrounding area. Then this is Dhopeshwar waterfall and surrounding area. Here evergreen and semi-evergreen type of forest patch, and it is found in Rajapur area only. Then this is Oni and Savatkadia areas of Rajapur and Lanja district area of Ratnagiri district. Here also we see semi-evergreen type of forest patch. This is Dongar village area. Is here deciduous type of forest and semi-evergreen type of forest. Ghat regions towards the east side of Konkan, while coastal region towards the west side of Konkan. This is coastal region. And in between Ghat region and coastal region, there are plateaus. Here, based on altitude, there are two types of plateaus: plateaus of low altitude and plateaus of high altitude. Low altitude lateratic plateaus are found in Konkan region, while high altitude plateaus are situated in Ghat region. Here, lateratic plateaus during summer season. Here you see it looks a dry, and there is it's like there is no vegetation, but the short life species of monsoon vegetation are usually neglected and missed by botanists as they completed their life cycle in short period. Such a short life endemic species are restricted on these plateaus. Here you see the beauty of lateratic plateaus during monsoon season. Even though these plateaus dry in summer, but here we took this photograph in the month of July, August from Konkan area of Maharashtra. Then this is Neonotis foetida. You see here the beauty of Neonotis. Though its smell is bad or foetid smell. Here you see the plant diversity on plateau, and my students are enjoying on these plateaus. Then here, this is Dipkadic Konkanensis. This is unique plant and endemic to this Konkan plateau only. And the name after Konkan region. And here you see my students are enjoying on this plateau in the month of July. This small land, small ponds on lateratic plateau, these ponds are very unique. And here the unique type of diversity in this pond. Here I'm showing one small pond near Jaitapur area, and how these ponds are very important. You see here, this is Jaitapur area, you know, this Jaitapur area is coming nuclear power plant coming on this Jaitapur area. You see, I have studied this seasonal variation at Jaitapur pond. The area of this pond is near about 100 square meter, and you see this seasonal variation of every month in June and July month. There is some small flower is there. Then July and August there is coriandra species is dominant. Then in the month of September, October, there are different species. Early summer, there is cryptocoryne patch, and February, March, there is vegetation is quite less. And you see in the month of April and May, it's look barren land. But how these ponds are important, you see in next slide. Here, in this pond, this peak flowering period at different season. Aponogeta nutaceae, this is peak flowering period in the month of June. In July, August, you will see entire coriandra flowering. Then in October and November month, you will get seen this Blixa octandra and Eriocolon raetianum. Then you see early summer cryptocoryne, and then after Pogostemum is in flowering. Since we have to critical study of each localities and cover, we have to cover entire season, all summer, monsoon and winter season, and we got benefit, and we have described 5 new species from single pond of Lateritic Plateau. I am happy to inform you that we have published this Eriocolon raetianum from the Jaitapur pond. Actually, this species name after our educational institute, Rait Shikshan Samstha, that's why the name is raetianum. You see here, this species is closely allied to Eriocolon cuspidatum, and here from naked eye you can distinguish Eriocolon raetianum and Eriocolon cuspidatum. You see the head of both species here. Then second beautiful species we have described, that is Coriandra elegans in 2016, and this is the world beautiful species in 2016. Here you see this panorama of Coriandra elegans in the month of July. This Coriandra elegans is allied to Coriandra chelidoni, and this species also described from this India. Here you see this differences of Coriandra elegans and Coriandra chelidoni. Here we have submitted type specimen of Coriandra to Kew, and you see the type specimen of Coriandra chelidoni in British Museum of Natural History, and you see here clear differences between Coriandra elegans and Coriandra chelidoni. Then here you see the flower, size of flower, then capsule beak, then leaf, middle leaf of this plant, then seed, differences in seed and differences in leaf. We have critical study more than 1 year, then we took decision to publish it. And this species published in Phytotaxa Journal. Here you see this beautiful flower of Coriandra elegans with 125 to 250 stamens. And here you see this Coriandra chelidoni with 35 to 60 stamens. then here my students are enjoying in the last week of July month for in Corinandra this population. Then third species from same pond, that is Aponogeton natishi, and this species, it is a unique in the world. You see here, this is my guide, Professor S.R. Yadav, and we have described this species. Here, you see here, Aponogeton natishi, it's globular unique embryo with 16 to 20 spirally arranged appendage, and this appendage not found in any known Aponogeton, and it's closely allied Aponogeton is, that is Aponogeton appendiculosis with 4 to 6 appendage. You see here the spike tuber of this Aponogeton, then submerged leaves of Aponogeton natishi. Then this is spike of Aponogeton natishi. Then fourth species, that is Eleucharis concinensis, we have described from same Jaitapur plant and the surrounding area. This is unique species because it's pentangular stem, one or two stamen, barb bristle, and papillate nut or akin surface. Here, this species neglected by taxonomies because of its minute flower, and there was no critical study. We have critical study 1 year of this population, and after that this species published in Phytotaxa International Journal, and the name is given after its Konkan region because its distribution in Konkan. Then you see here, this is spike and habitat of Eleucharis concinensis. You see here differences of Eleucharis concinensis and its allied species Eleucharis setifolia. Then fifth species, that is Pogostemon. We have analysis this species 2 year, and this species compare with our endemic, this another endemic plant, that is Pogostemon deccanensis and Pogostemon erectus, and this species is clearly distinct from Pogostemon deccanensis and Pogostemon erectus by different characters, and we have communicated this paper to journal, and still it is unpublished. Then another species, that is Cryptocorin, we have studied critically of its flower, then its tube. This species does not match with any known species of Cryptocorin, and still further study is going on. Here you see the flower of and tuber and this habit of Cryptocorin. This, all these five, six species are found on this 100 square meter area of Jaitapur, this pond, and actually this area acquired by this Jaitapur nuclear power plant, and this Jaitapur nuclear power plant, as well as mining activities, may be the threat for this species. This not only plateau areas important, other area of Konkan also important. This coastal region, this is also very important. This is another example of Eleucharis. This Eleucharis dulcis is common species of coastal region, and this allied species is Eleucharis neglecta. Recently we have described. Actually, taxonomists neglected this species because it looks like similar or marshy habitat. Here we have described this neglecta. You see in photo plate, this in habitat, we see this Eleocheirus neglecta and Eleocheirus dulcis shows differences in morphological also. Here, in another important character, in Eleocheirus dulcis, the culm is soft, deep green, flat after pressing and drying, whereas in Eleocheirus neglecta, it is sub-rigid culm, yellowish to pale green and slender after pressing and drying. And you see other characters also. And actually it is a common species, but it is neglected species. And number of herbaria, this neglecta species are wrongly identified, this species wrongly identified as a Eleocheirus dulcis. After critical study, and we have this published this paper in Bangladesh Journal of Plant Taxonomy. This another species of Cryptocoryne, that is Cryptocoryne cognata. This species earlier reported as extinct from this planet, but recently we have located some good population in Konkan region, and this is also unique species and it is restricted in Konkan region. Then another unique species, Wisneria triandra, this is also endemic species and it is found in lateritic plateaus on Konkan region. Then this is Blixa ichinosperma, this is also endemic species. You know mangrove and it's important. Mangrove diversity found in coastal region towards the west side of Konkan region. Mangrove protect shoreline from damaging storm, wave and flood. Mangrove also help protect erosion by stabilizing sediment with their tangled root system. They maintain water quality and clarity. Total 110 mangrove species reported throughout the world, while in India about 25 species are reported. And I have seen about 17 species of mangroves towards the west coast of Ratnagiri area. These are some mangrove genera, this Brugeria, then Lumnigera, Sonericia, Avicinia, Rhizophora, Aegisiros, Acanthus, then Sonericia, Exocaria, etc. Generally, we see the beauty of plateaus during monsoon season only. And we have neglected these plateaus during summer season because it's looked dry or barren land. But during summer season, survey is also very important. Here, you see these plateaus in summer with Lepidogyathis species. And we have critical study of this plateau in summer also. And we got unique species on this plateau in summer. You see here, Lepidogyathis triangli and Lepidogyathis ushai. These two species we have recently described from lateritic plateaus of Konkan region. And this species is unique and found is flowering in summer season, especially in March and April. The first species is Lepidogyathis triangli. This species published after the name of my guru, Professor S.R. Yadav. And last month, another species published in Q Bulletin, that is Lepidogyathis ushai. This species we have my student and published my student Borude and Nateker. This is collaborative work and we have published this species in Q Bulletin. You see this very beautiful flower in summer season, and this case is published after the name of Dr. Usha Sriranga Yadav, and we gave the name because of her contribution in cytotaxonomy of Western Ghat area. Here you see this habitat. This species found on lateritic plateaus in summer season, both Lepidogyathis Sriranga and Lepidogyathis Usha. Here you see the Lepidogyathis Sriranga is clearly distinguished from Lepidogyathis Lutea. This Lepidogyathis Lutea also described from Konkan region, and it is endemic species. Here Lutea white's yellow color flower, and other characters, differences, you see leaf differences, then this bright, this stem angle, and that's why we have described as a new species. Here, this is Lepidogyathis Ushai, this leaf in rainy season, then leaf in summer season. Then we have studied throughout the year, and after that we publish it in Q Bulletin. This species is closely allied to Lepidogyathis carolensis. This species described from Kerala before 30 years back by Dr. N.P. Singh and Dr. Madhusunar. This another area also important, not only plateaus, but in Konkan region, another areas, we have collected interesting species. You see, this is Ipomea aquilata, night blooming flower, and this flower size is about 25 centimeter, and it is unique plant, and this plant first time reported from Konkan region of Maharashtra. This is some unique plant, that is Syzygium stocksi, tree species. Is Aglaia talboti. This is also tree species. The Hygropia serphylum variety Hookeriana, and this is Herbaceous, and Ipomea salsitaceous. This is climber. This species, no one has collected after its type types collection. Means this Syzygium stocksi we have collected after 150 years. From its type collection, this Aglaia talboti also we have collected after 100 year. Then this Ipomea salsitensis we have reported after its type collection 60 year. And these all unique species, and this rediscovered from Konkan region recently. This is Camptorhiza indica, and recently we have this name changed. This is Iphigenia ratnagirica. This species described by my guide Professor S.R. Yadav and other. This is unique species and restricted to the lateritic plateaus of Ratnagiri area only. And recently we have described, we have located this species other localities of Rajapur area. About one third endemic species are found in Western Ghat, and some 1700 species, endemic species are reported in Western Ghat, and about 58 genera of flowering plants are endemic to Western Ghat. And we have collected about 150 species, endemic species from Konkan region, and these all species are unique and restricted only this region. So here you see the beauty, some beautiful species of beautiful rare and endemic species we have located from this Rajapur area only. Then you see here, this is monotypic and endemic tree species that is pneumococcus pneumoniae. This species found in both Ghat region as well as in Konkan region. Then here you see this some medicinal plant, that is Notochordaitis foetida, earlier name was Mapia foetida. This flower smell is foetid or bad smell, and it is reported medicinally reported. Then this is second species, this Saraka ashoka, the earlier name was Saraka indica, or in local name it is called as Sitesa ashok. This is also highly medicinal plant, and these two plants found in Konkan region. This is Memesolam umbellatum. This is common species, common on lateritic plateau, but it is restricted only this our Western Ghat and Konkan region. Memesolam umbellata can easily identify by its margin. You see here this leaf margin and flower in umbel. Then some species recently described after the name of Konkan, that is Amorphylus konkanensis, then Dipkadi konkanensis. Actually Dipkadi konkanensis was described before 150 year back. Then Euphorbia konkanensis, Triathura konkanensis, then Eleucharis konkanensis, Syropyga konkanensis, etc. Here, legume, about 775 species of legume are reported from India, and some important legumes we have collected from Konkan region, some important genera, that is Desmodium, then Stylosanthus, Smithia, Crotalaria, then Vigna, Teprosia, etc. And most of legumes are endemic to this our region. Then you know this insectivorous plant. Here our region, there are two genera of this insectivorous plant, that is one is Drosera and second is Utricularia. There are two species of Drosera reported from our region, Drosera indica and Drosera burmani, and some 25 to 30 species of Utricularia reported from our region. And you see this some 8-9 species of Utricularia, and this species of Utricularia I have reported from our college area, and the area is about 35 acre only. Means this 7-8 to 9 species found only our college campus area. And you see these species are unique and beautiful, and also this lifespan very short, or it is ephemeral species. Here this is unique family Apocynaceae, and this member of Apocynaceae, that is this beautiful species, beautiful genus Syropyga, then Brachystelma, then Holostemma, Heterostemma, etc. About 4,500 species are reported from entire world, and from India 4,025 species are recently reported from family Apocynaceae, and about 75 species are reported from the region. Here you see this flower. These all are night blooming flowers. Here the family Convolvulaceae is the dominant or maximum members of family Convolvulaceae, and we have reported means one of my colleague Professor S.L. Salunke sir, and my other colleague, we have reported this about 50 species from this Rajapur and surrounding area of this night blooming group. Here you see some herbaceous beautiful flowers, that is Eriocolon, Cyperus, Sinusio, Barleria, Exercum, then Impatient, Gloriosa, Dipteri, Habenaria. And this herbaceous species we can cultivate, or we can use as a wild ornamental plant. Here, this is about more than 3,000 tree species are reported from India. And from last 5 years, we have reported about 175 tree species from Konkan area. This is another important group of family Orchidaceae, called as orchid. Here, about 1,300 species of orchids are reported from India. Here you see this beautiful species of orchid. Approximately 48 to 49% orchids are terrestrial. Remaining 48 to 49% orchids also form epiphyte, and remaining 1 to 2% orchids are saprophyte. Here we have collected some 70 species of orchid from Konkan region. Here we can use orchid for commercial cultivation. This, for example, here this Phalaenopsis species, here cultivated in some areas of our Maharashtra and this Belgaum area of Karnataka. Here you see this some beautiful orchid, that is Polydata pallida and Rhynchostylis retusa. Polydata is generally called as necklace orchid. It look like necklace, that's why it's called as necklace orchid. And another this orchid Rhynchostylis, commonly here this rural area or this forest area, this forest is this orchid is called as Sitichi vini. This is grass, you know, this important of grass. Generally grasses are neglected, but family level this grass we can identify, means family we can easily recognize grass family. Here grassland. Economically, grass is very important. These four species, for example, GM, Tritium, Oryza sativa, and sugar. These four species are fulfill our 80% food requirement. And this is, that's why this family is economically as well as ecologically very important group. Grasses are neglected because of its minute flower, or it is difficult to dissect. But you see the beauty of this grass spikelet, and with the help of this spikelet, we can identify grasses at generic as well as species level. And here you see this gloom, lower gloom of these grasses, and you see augmentation of this gloom. This is unique species, and from last 5 years we have reported about 150 grass species from this Konkan region. Here one example, this is Glypoclova. One of my friend Dr. Kosavi is working on this group, Dr. this Glypoclova. You see here this lower gloom of Glypoclova. Glypoclova is restricted only plateaus, high altitude plateau as well as low altitude plateau. And here this is lower gloom, is very unique. And you see this all figure, it's lower gloom, and with the help of its lower gloom we can identify each and every species of grass. Some monotypic endemic genera, and this also found on lateritic plateaus only, that is Danthonidium gami, and another Indopova popercula. Here, this Hubbardia heptanura. Actually, earlier this was endemic. Monotypic, means only single species. But recently we have described another species, that is Hubbardia dihandra. This Hubbardia heptanura is restricted only on zoophyll area, and Hubbardia dihandra we found at Tillari region of Kolhapur district. Why I am showing this plate? You see here, this is a distinct, how to distinct spikelet. Dihandra with long spikelet with long hairs, whereas Hubbardia heptanura with spread hairs. Recently, under this WWF conservation program, we have reintroduced this Hubbardia dihandra in Konkan region, and most of area these populations are successful and survival. This another species that is Heteropogon tritaceus, it is also found in Konkan region. Then this is Spinifex littoralis. This species are restricted on coastal region. Then another group, stages. Stages are related by taxonomies, botanies, because of its minute flower, non-attractive flower. Then it grows on marshy area. But if you have good literature, if you have camera, and if you have microscope, we can identify each and every species of sedges. Sedges generally, you see here, this is its fruit, or it's called as nut. Its nut is unique for identification. Here you see this beautiful sedges that is Eleucharis grows in marshy habitat in Konkan region. This is another endemic plant in Lankana, recently described by Dr. Vodut Khan sir, and it is also found in Konkan region. And you see here this marshy habitat. Then Eleucharis philippinensis, this species recently we have described, recently we have collected from Sindhudurga area, and earlier this species was reported from Philippine country, and now it is reported as a new record for our country. Here you see this fruit of Cypressea member, and this is unique type of fruit, or generally we call as nut. Its nuts is unique, or identification of all sedges from its nut. You see here this character, nut surface, then bristle, this bar bristle, smooth bristle, akin, and with this nut we can identify it and every species of the beauty of this nut. And here some species, here you see this akin, here revived one genus, that is Eleucharis for India, and with the help of this akin or nut, we can identify each and every species. You see the ACM plate here, and every species is distinct. Morphologically, it is very difficult for identification, but for nut character, we can identify. This is photograph of all 32 species of Eleucharis from India. And here you see this nut is unique of each species. Then bristle, then nut surface, some bristle are smooth, some bristle are barb, some bristle are plumose, nut color also, nut shape also, and these all character we consider for its species level. Then after this, you know, these grasses, sedges, third important group is Eriocolon or Eulacaceae. These three families are generally neglected by people because of its minus and difficult flower. But you see, in Eriocolaceae in India, the single genus Eriocolon, here about 80 to 90% species of Eriocolon we can clearly distinguish from its head only. And you see this head of some Eriocolon, and each head is different, and we can identify all species of Eriocolon with the help of its head. In India, about 105 species are reported, and most of species are endemic, and about 20 species are described from India during last decade. Then another beautiful, this is Trithia concunnins. This plant is very small. The size is hardly about up to 1 centimeter. This species is described from my guide Professor S.R. Yadav from Vaibhavwadi area of Ratnagiri district during 1990. Because this, why this species is unique? Because you see this habit, and here this unique family Hydatilis is because its all members are found in Australia, and the first this family added to our country Hydatilis in the form of Trithia concunnins. This beautiful photo I have taken in front of my college area, the Rajapur area. This is Bombax insigne, and this is dispersal fruit, dispersal phenomenon. I capture this photograph when heavy wind. So then this is Chlorophytum. This is important genus. This is important. In India, this Chlorophytum, about 24 species are reported, and 7 species of this genera reported, described during last decade by different scientists. Here, some species that is Chlorophytum laxum, Chlorophytum limoni. These are found in Konkan region. Chlorophytum glaucum, Chlorophytum glaucoides. This species on the found in high altitude area is Ghat region in Ratnagiri and Dudhuga district. Even this Chlorophytum botanus also described from botany area of Ratnagiri district. This is Gingiber officinale, and you know this ginger. And here the member of order Gingiberales of Costa, Alpinia, the Puma.
Hello.
Sir, and your yes, slides sir. Are also visible. Please.
Yes, yes, sir. Okay, thank you, sir. This is gingival officinal. You know, this is ginger. And here you see the other members of order gingivorales, that is costus, alpinia, curcuma, amomum, then elitaria, gingivore, and some cultivated member, that is Canna, heliconia, sterligia, ravenella, and another important, this Musa genus. These all member, and most of these species of gingers are found in contagion. Here, another important group, this is member of Commelinaceae. This Commelina, then Cynotis, Murdania, these some species are found in Konkan region. Here, palm, most of the palm species are cultivated, and it is economically very important group. Some wild species, that is Calamus, Phoenix, Corypha, Aringa, Pinenga, etc. Are found in Western Ghat and Konkan region. This is another important group, that is Araceae. And here we know this is unique flower of this group, that is paddock type of inflorescence. And here this is, you see this genus, some photos of Amorphylus. About 26 genera and 125 species of Araceae are reported from India. Here in Amorphylus, you see this pair, male flower, then female flower, and in between some time, neuter flowers are present. And you see this appendage. Appendage also different. Then, you know this plant, this is Pandanus, or in local name is called as Kevda, and it is found in coastal region. Here, this is Pandanus odoratissimus. And you see this fruit and habit of Pandanus odoratissimus. It is restricted in coastal region. This is NCT superbum. Generally, it is found in slope region, and it is also endemic species. It's found in Ghat and Konkan region. Then another important genus, Iphigenia. After first shower of monsoon, this Iphigenia pallida, Iphigenia stellata, Iphigenia indica, and other species of Iphigenia are generally found. And this is ephemeral plant, ephemeral genus, and it is closely allied to this Camptorhiza. Then Barleria, you know this, it belongs to family Acanthaceae, or its local is called as Coranti. Here some species of Barleria we have collected from plateau area as well as undergrowth of forest, that is Barleria prinotis, Barleria cuspidata, Barleria invariocata, then Barleria pratensis, Barleria cristata, Barleria crandiflora estata. Here already I told that this Cygnium stocksii, this is a unique tree species. It is endemic and it is reported as a critical endanger category of IUCN red data list. Here this species was described as a Eugenia stocksii in 1879 by Dutti, and later this species named as Cygnium stocksii in 1991. But actually it's type collection from Konkan region. And after this collection, nobody has collected this species from Maharashtra, and no one reported even different flora, that is flora of British India, flora of Cook, Maharashtra. This species is not collected. Recently, we have collected or reported this species from Konkan area. Generally, it grows on this stream area. You see this unique habitat, and
the small size of fruit. Therefore, we take some effort for its conservation. We collected seed in the month of May, and we prepare some seedlings of this species in our college campus with the help of our NSS and our botany student. We prepared about 1,000 seedlings of this critical endangered, globally critical endangered plant, that is Cygium stoxa. You see here these seedlings of Cygium stoxa in our college poly house. And I'm proud, we have distributed this seedling to various colleges and forest department free of cost, because we want to conservation only of this critical endangered plant. And this is we can grow this species by its conventional method of seed germination. And this is very next some photographs of this plant. You know, this this Konkan is famous for this cashew nut, then mango, then rice and palm. This is some cultivated photos and some wild photo also here. Now we have limited time, that's why I'm showing just some slides, photographs of Konkans. You see here. And this is Chlorophytum brevis capum, Barlaria, then Cirrhopegia, then Rowlfia, Erinocarpus. This endemic species and found in Konkan region. Here you see some Pandanus, then Amorphylus, Tucka, then here Utricularias, some ginger, etc. Here you see orchid and other some this Mamia plant. Now this I'm happy to inform you that this species we have described from Konkan region, this species published on cover page of various journal, that is Apan Jotan published on Redia cover page, while this Cornandra elegans published on Phytotaxa journal cover page. And this our contribution also recognized by Ministry of Environment and Forest. This Cornandra elegans published on Plant Discoveries of 2006, which was published by Ministry of Environment and Forest, MOEF. And this Eleuchery species, three Eleuchery species, that is Eleuchery lankana, Eleuchery conconensis, Eleuchery neglecta, published in Young Scientist DST report for page. And thank you everyone.
Hello, sir. Thank you, sir, for such a wonderful talk with beautiful slides. Your talk will enlighten us on plant diversity of Konkan. Now, let's move towards question and answer session. Dear participants, I request you to raise your questions in chat box.
Are you?
Yes.
Okay. So first question is that how
number of
Ghats are present in Konkan area
and Western Ghats
which are red grass
species. Which are red grass species. Please sir.
Actually, actually no detail report, but actually my observation I have studied. I have reported about 15 genera from Konkan area.
Okay. And next question is that does pollination occurs in Korean and dry ligands?
Yes, this Korean yes occur.
Okay. Another question is that what major difference are found in between mangroves of Konkan and mangroves of Sundarban?
Actually. This difference in this here hello
sir you are audible sir
actually there is no difference but some species naipa is restricted on naipa species palm actually it is in mangrove and okay, it is restricted in this Sundarban area whereas here our region some 17 species I have seen.
Hello.
Hello.
Haan, sir. So, sir, another question is there that is there is any work doing in Arbuscular Mycorrhizal Association in Gingivaraceae?
No, no, sir. Actually, I have do taxonomy only, taxonomic work. Hello.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir. Due to limitations, we have selected few questions from chat box. Now, I request convener of this webinar, Sri S. N. Jadhav sir, to propose vote of thanks. Sir, it's over to you. Hello. Sir, please unmute your.
Hello.
Okay, sir, you are audible now.
Now the time has to be expressed vote of thanks. It's my privilege to propose a vote of thanks, Mr. Suresh Jadhav, on behalf of Rajasthan Sanstha, Sharad Chandra Kumar Mahavidyalaya, Department of Planning. Excellent. Very thanks to our guest speaker, Mr. Arun Sanduri, who gives energetic webinar on plant diversity of Konkan. I am sure your guidance will be definitely help our participant to think about different aspects of conservation of plant diversity. Thank you for your guidance. Also thank our for giving us the opportunity to conduct this national webinar. Also thanks all the faculties for constant support and guidance and encouragement in this webinar. At last, but not the least, I thank all participants for patiently attending the webinar. Special thanks to all administrative and supporting staff of Sharad Mahavidyalaya
known providing all technical support. I am also thankful to my colleague Dr. Mara Atone, Radhika Chauhan, and Damayanti Chaudhary. Their assistance in organizing this national webinar with the chair, I declare that the webinar is over. Thank you.